as high as it'll go, how does that work? Well, Peter Brazzi knocked to the door, but he was a very poor business manager, and he went, he was broke by the time he was in his later years. Well, he died in Denver in January 1917. The Denver, city of Denver, and the Rocky of the Denver Post, the newspaper in Denver, recognize some potential for a tourist attraction if they buried Bill Cody there in Denver. So they offered his wife $20,000 to allow them to bury. Sitting like that for 7 years, the family refuses to sell it or to try to finish it, whatever it was, and so we bought it to Pagoda, and that's it. Okay, back to the buffalo, which is going to lead me eventually back to the wolf. The Park Service didn't maintain. During the winter, this valley is a very important wildlife wintering area. There will be somewhere in the neighborhood of 400 to 500 head of elk that'll matter here, and 150 or so bighorn sheep. Most of them now pull back. You don't see them too much this time of year. I did find three ewes. This highway is open year-round. It's plowed. It's a U.S. highway, and it is plowed by the state of Wyoming up to Pahaska Teepee, which is about 12 miles on up the country. At Pahaska, the flying stops at the east entrance.
Say hi to Yellowstone. Yeah. We're looking for a grizzly bear.
Place 391 feet and averages about 190. It is the core, if you will, of a huge volcanic eruption. About 630,000 years ago, there was an eruption that the earth scientists and the geologists tell us was 1,000 times more powerful than Mount St. Helens. It put out enough material in this yet. Like this monster wheel, and we haven't picked him up yet. There's some folks up here looking uphill, and there's usually an old bull buffalo, a bachelor bull, living up here. I said, yeah, there he is right
there.
There
he is.
Now, during the course of the day, we should see several buffalo, of those, so we won't take any.
A buffalo. We're going to see plenty of buffalo up here.
Bachelor bull is a bull that has been beat out of the herd by a younger, more aggressive herd bull. Now, I've touched on the grizzly bear issue several times in each state to try to bring some consistency to those three clans.
Thank you.
Yeah. This is the yellow, the Old Faithful Hotel.
No, he's not here.
It's cool.
It's nice.
Here we are, Old Faithful. We're waiting for the geyser to go off. Okay. No, they don't. There's nobody over there. See, over there.
See, there's people off in the balcony.
I couldn't see it from the balcony. I was up there.
I've got it on panorama.
Well, don't put it on panorama for this one. You can put it on panorama to get the big things. Just, when it comes up, we're going to have plenty of time to shoot it. I guess they're waiting for one over there to go off. Geyser. It's trying. There it goes. Whoops. It goes up pretty high. Let's go, geyser.
That poor Indian guy needs a job.
It keeps teasing us.
Give him 20 years. Somebody else shot him.
There it goes. Go on, do more than that. Yeah.
The fact is that forest manager, if you want to manage the forest, you gotta manage it. Yeah. You end up with what happens in the real world, which is enormous wildfire.
Come on, geyser.
I mean, all through the history of North America, it's been. Look at the Great Plains.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, he's getting ready. There it goes. There it goes. You got a picture? Did you get it, hon?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Get a couple of pictures.
I did.
Okay.
About five. Don't get even higher. Well, it's outside the ring. Gotta have to zoom out here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That goes for a while.
We can review them on the bus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to get it all. I flew that tiger 15 hours to see this stupid geyser.
Pumping out some water.
Yeah, it is.
still pumping.
12,000.
I mean, see, they average 12,000 for, you know, if they didn't have this rule there, you'd have guys like us flying their planes through that thing.
Yeah.
Getting a wash job, yep. It'd be one of those things you'd have to tell people you did, right?
Yeah, I flew a thrill paper.
It's like flying through the arc. It's not good.
There he is. He's going to play.
Damn, this is a long one, thing.
Bridge over the canal once in Panama. It was a helicopter.
Yeah. It goes off for quite some time, doesn't it?
Yeah. Must be a lot of water bills up in there.
It's more than a minute.
They said 10 to 12,000 gallons per eruption.
Yeah. There's the yellow water. Huh. All right. Popping. Huh. Yeah, it goes all the way up.
Real good example of what happens. Those cones all opened shortly after the fire. This is the Fire Hole River, and 90% of the water in this river comes from the geysers and the hot springs. Up here, it's still too hot to maintain a fishery. You're down about 10 miles, it cools down enough that the trout can't live in it. In fact, it's fairly large streams of freezing hot water coming out of that spring. Spring, and that water, when it first surfaces, is just under boiling temperature. Mm. The comment made here that you can cook your hot dog in that. If you look through the pictures, they
no, you shouldn't have. Yeah. But it's hot in there.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It'll fill your face.
That's something to see. Where you don't want to get off of this walkway. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That would be a good one for us to do this.
There goes a hat.
Collecting shed elk antlers is quite a pastime. It's fun to get out in the backcountry, and it also can be fairly lucrative to do that. Campers.
Yeah, that's about the best place to get it right here. Man, the wind is howling, hon. Here, get right over there a little closer. Huh? I just didn't want to lose my hat. I can stick my hand.
I think I'd bring the
hat. That must be a heck of a shot there. Those people right on the edge of the falls. Can you see that?
There's people standing over there.
There's people standing. Right,
yeah.
The
yeah. Standing over there.
How does he build a nest up there like that?
He says, "Hey, nobody gonna get me here."
Here's some elk over here behind us, 9 o'clock, those are elk.
at a buffalo. Hundreds of.
Yeah. These are elk, yeah. Way back down here in the meadow. Those are elk. All those are bison, oh, yeah. Buffalo up there.
The elk went back there, see them right by the river.
Yeah,
it's a little further along, that gets a little more aggressive.
Right in the right spot. There's our airplane. There goes the airliner coming in.
Even those are our first timers, it's still feel welcome. I think so.
This is the line for food. Oh, somebody's ordered
hey,
here.
Well,
like
I didn't
here.
Mean to cut you off yesterday because you were offering all sorts of things.
Right.
Barbecue for the AYA. Standing in line here. We'll see what Dave Fletcher's got for sale over there. Buffalo burgers. So they won't believe me back home that I'm eating buffalo burgers without taking a picture of this box. All right, this is back the airplane without a tow bar. We gotta go see your museum right now. Oh, hon. Does it say one on it? Still, then you didn't push the button. Okay. Roll of film coming up. All right. We're at the Buffalo Bill Museum. That's a moose. There's another picture of Buffalo Bill over there. Now I want to go to this one first. Now. This is the reason, the main reason.
The Buffalo Bills.
Yeah. That's what Haas used.
Uh-huh. Which one is?
Where's Haas right there?
Yeah, I'm seeing it. That's his right here.
Yeah. There's the pistols.
I think you can see it now with the video.
Yeah. And there's a movie. Oh, there's a Bat Masterson.
The real one, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, there's an Uzi. It's just got a wide open barrel because you can put anything in it, bolts, nuts, rocks. Yeah.
This one to these two?
Yeah. Those are all flintlocks there. Yeah. It was a flintlock, but these were getting more reliable now. And these are percussions.
Well, these people wouldn't have put up with
them. What?
These people had these guns, wouldn't put up with them.
Oh, no. Now, these are percussions here, so they're getting them more modern. Ration repeaters.
Yeah. You know, see, we could buy whole new outfits here.
Yeah.
You get whole new Western stuff now. Mm-hmm. You can learn the line dance.
Look at that funny looking rifle. Yeah. Well, these are bolt actions. Yeah. These are modern arms there. And that's real modern stuff there. That's a 45 with a stock, World War II. I guess this is kind of that's where Mookie thinks he is. That's a grizzly, so you see how big they are.
Take a picture of it too?
Yeah. Right here, look at this. This is a Remington going into battle. Was having a big steak for breakfast.
Good size.
Yeah. Well, you can smell all the oil and stuff on the lathes. No, I'm just seeing what's over here. I guess some traps. Oh no, they're some kind of skis.
Well, it does snow here.
Yeah. Well, this was the hardware store in the old days. Yeah.
Over.
M16.
What's this yellow thing for?
Well, that just cut open so you can see the inside, what it looks like. The Gatling gun. All Savage. Well, those are famous little Parker shotguns. Really expensive.
Well, you know, I guess that's why people buy all these antiques, because the value just goes up and up.
Well, especially Parkers. Parkers are...
Thank you.
There's Spencer. Look at this. Huh? Do what? There's both my guns, 59 and a 66. There must be every damn gun ever made in here. Funny looking gun.
That's a rocket one.
Show me. These are all Winchesters.
It's hot in here.
Let me look at this thing. What kind of gun is that? Oh, these are BB guns. Air guns. All the guns. They're all shotguns. Gazillion shotguns. Trap shooter guns. Yeah. Game getter, shotgun, rifle. Auto burglar, B-shot. AK-47s, Ithaca, yeah, let me sweep these. Oh yeah, I've seen these. Yeah, yeah. Little buckle guns.
Freedom.
One of five made. Yeah.
And this is what.
Look at those.
Yeah, pretty.
Oh yeah.
And this one, Nathan Bedford Forrest. Is that?
Yeah.
Saying, where was
well, we had Forrest in high school, but he was a general driver.
Yeah.
I'm running out of battery here.
Oh,
well,
you
have
to get it.
Yeah. Another Colt. Excuse me. Oh, man. The Buntline Special.
Oh, it's just a long way.
It's a Buntline. Railroad. See, here's a Purdy. Greener. Greener. Holland and Holland. Yeah. Red jacket.
Is it a headdress?
Yeah, it's capes. Birds, almost in the background. They use that to probably convert the Indians sensitive motherwood. Custer is getting killed. I guess this is where Custer bought it. Yeah, there he is right there, getting chewed up. Custer Hill. Battle of Greasy Grass, Little Bighorn, 1876. Burying a cowpoke. Custer had a problem that day. Just fit it in the picture. Yeah. Buffalo Bill, he's saving this woman here. There he is, killing that Indian who was getting ready to scalp this lady. Indians going after these buffaloes. In Wyoming, it's kind of neat.
Let me introduce you to the cast. I'm Wild Bill. I came up here tonight because my friend Buffalo Bill had to go out on the South Fork, worked over at GE Ranch. Said he'd be back tomorrow night. I was hoping he'd be back tonight. So I asked him if he wanted me to watch over with a good friend of mine, the gentleman right there, nice, good-looking women, Mr. Who do you think? Yep.
This mic ain't working very well.
No, that's Doc Holliday! Now the one in red there, sitting next to him. Now that leads me down to the riffraff.
Shut up, both of you.
See that little fuzzy one in the middle? That one with all the fuzzy hair? That is one of the meanest little hombres you will ever meet. He's in the Wyoming State Penitentiary with a gun, and he swore up taken alive. Ladies and gentlemen, that's Kid Rue. Now you see the one on the end down there in the black hat and the white shirt? Heard that into that one on the Santa Fe Trail. I didn't know if it was a man or a woman. But I'll tell you what, after meeting that mean hombre, I figured that was the meanest woman I ever met in my life. That there is Beretta Maverick. Now we're getting back.
That bar back there, Queen Elizabeth gave that to Buffalo Bill. Yeah, that bar backing. I heard the story about that the other day.
Every plane we fly from an AA-1K to a GA-7, an AA-1 slick wing can handle 90 knots.
Grumman's everywhere. Pretty good picture. Probably don't get to see that many Grummans lined up like that very often.
If you want to hop up on the...
Oh, this is good. We got a good shot right here. He's not going to drop his bomb from that distance, I don't think, is he? Yeah, canopy's open, right?
It's open.
Yeah. Yeah. He almost got the guy on the ground. Yeah.
When that time is, and
yeah. He missed it. Must be some kind of new tiger with four-bladed prop. Sure looks like it's a Len Care tiger. Japs out here. Stuck them out here. I guess that's one of the last of the houses. Novelties at Powell. Oh, look at this, Hansel and Gretel's. But there's good Mexican food in there. Okay, we're in Powell, Wyoming, and this is the Homesteader Museum. This is a really beautiful little town. Must not be no Walmart here.
I think I forgot to bring with me all my counseling tablets.
A Firestone TV. Yeah, I got that old machine.
What is it?
It's a calculator. Beat puller. Corn planter. That little motor.
It's only one time.
It's here, the one.
There we go. There's the big man right there. Okay.
saying, we're so awesome.
A naturalist's cabin.
If you see somebody that works here, you need to ask if there's a way out the back door.
Well, I don't think so. That's a mountain goat. Well, we're right there at Cody. And that's where we were yesterday. We're right next to Idaho. Moose is scratching himself. The beaver pond. You see Mr. Beaver down there. This is a beaver mound. Brown bear. No, it's different buffaloes. There's some buffalo fur if you want to touch it. Bill died in 1921. I just saw. Chuck wagon. Sheep wagon. Or sheep herder.